I'm turning to a freak.
Rich, rich can't pay my expenses. Queen for a day like a fucking big fantastic.
Oh my god, I don't want to get the fuck up. Good morning, besties. It is Thursday, June 22nd, 11:52 a.m. I woke up like... So this weekend is SoWhat Festival on the 24th and 5th in Dallas, Texas. I'm flying my ass all the way from California to Texas to see a number of bands, but mostly Pierce the Veil. Y'all know me. Seeing Pierce the Veil again, Sleeping with Sirens again, and then I see Pierce the Veil again next weekend here in my hometown. Although I have balcony seats for that show, so that's kind of why I made up with this festival experience. I just think festival experiences are so awesome. So I haven't been since when we were young last year. I'm excited to vlog it for you guys. I'm excited to experience it. I'm meeting up with some content creator friend. It's gonna be a really great time. With that being said, today, what's on the list is I need to get up. I need to go shower right now. Do my, like, everything shower because I'm gonna be in Texas all weekend. So, and I'm flying. So, like, there's a lack of things you can take, you know? I need to go take my shower and then I need to go do my eyebrows. After that, I'm gonna go ahead and get ready for my day, do makeup, get ready. I gotta record some content to schedule. There is some requests on TikTok for some videos, so I'm gonna get, like, all that stuff out of the way so that I have, like, content stacked up for myself the next couple days and when I'm burnt out when I come back, because I know I'm going to be if I don't have, like, some sort of festival flu. After that, I need to pack. I need to pack. Good thing about that is I made it easy. I kind of already planned my outfits for day one and two. I just need to kind of, like, figure out what I'm wearing. The airport, home and back, or there and back, and then take PJs and shit, so... Yeah, I will get back to you guys after my little shower. See you then. Bye. Mwah.
This is the outfit for today, besties. Just the boondocks, the ducks, some little shorts I have underneath here because I'm lazy and I didn't want to get any clothes too dirty because I've got a pack. I've literally got a pack. I just recently got this Bad Omen shirt, so I'm gonna wear it today. That's the outfit. Very simp, very cash, very simp. Yeah, anyways.
Hello, besties. I'm in the car now, heading to get my eyebrows done. Vlogging is so odd to me because, like, I don't know, I'm so used to, like, going about my errands in my daily life alone, individualistically. Is that a word? Someone fact check me. Individually, I guess individually, right? And I just, like, I don't have RBFs. Like, I just walk around, like, mind my business just because, like, I hate the general public. Love y'all, though. Hate the general public. Y'all know what I mean. If you know, you know. I like vlogging. It's just I'm not comfortable with it yet, I think. So it's gonna be weird vlogging, like, at the festival and stuff. I think I'm just a little anxious that, like, I overthink too much. So, like, I, like, put thoughts in people's heads for them. And, like, I just am, like, I definitely know they're thinking that I look fucking weird. Or I'm a loser. And no one gives a fuck. So
there's a fucking, there's ducklings. I want to get a video of it. That is so fucking cute. Holy shit. Oh no. Oh, that is so fucking sweet. And they, oh, they helped. Oh, and they helped. Oh, how fucking awesome.
I'm heading in to get my eyebrows done. Here's the before. A little before. I'm a little crusty dusty right now, y'all. Don't worry. Give me, like, 2 minutes into the video. Y'all can skip it. Oh, my God, my eye bags. My brow lady gets me right every single fucking time. Sorry I'm a little overexposed right now, but here's, like, the overview of the after. I'm gonna go ahead and head home. Why do I feel like that's, like, fucked up? There we go. Someone's, like, in the view. Slay, queen, girl boss. This dude's watching me in his fucking windshield. He's like in directly in front of me and he's watching me. Hey, bestie. Bestie boo. Anyways, I think I'm gonna head to Best Buy and see if I can get an SD card for the trip and then head home and get ready, do makeup for the day. Yeah. And then that'll be that. Okay, I have just left Best Buy, and I got my SD card. Got the 256 gigabyte because a girl like me likes to record concerts. Anyways, and then I got a new like phone case because y'all, look at this. Look how fucking disgusting this is. Look at that. Isn't that disgusting? The difference on that? Like, why is that a thing? It was like an open box. That was only like $6. So I was like, fuck. I really want to get a privacy screen protector. So if I can find one of those, that'd be really fucking dope. Because people be all up in your business and I'm about to be in an airport and I have to post content, reply to shit, and I hate, and also like sitting on a plane with like my, like, nah, I'm good. I don't want these people to see my phone, you know? And my shit's all fucked up and cracked anyway, so it's time. It like causes reflections and shit.
I'm home now. I am about to do my makeup, but really cool little story, let me tell you guys. So if you don't know me, anything about me. Hi, my name is Nessa. I'm a content creator and streamer. I've been doing this since 2019. Since I dropped out of college. So, funny little story. I just, like, got a check from my college for, like, $60. I mean, it's nothing big. It's, like, $60. But it's money. I don't know why. It doesn't say why. It literally is just a check. But I'm gonna take it. No questions asked. Hi besties, I just finished my makeup. I have some content that I would like to record because I sent some stuff over to the editor, or my editor, so he can work on and I can schedule some things to post while I am gone and recovering from said vacation because I know I'm gonna be fucking shot. I'm so excited, I still gotta pack. It is now 5:33 p.m. I always take forever to get ready. But like I said, I'm probably gonna eat dinner here soon. Record some content and then get to pack it. Hello, frenzies. It is about, honestly, I don't even know what time it is. It's 8:19. I've done nothing. I did have dinner. Didn't show you guys dinner. I just had like a little club Sammy that my dad made me. And then I did do some singing downstairs. And then I've just been kind of like sitting here filming content for TikTok. Now, I think I'm gonna run to Target because I actually need to get some new fishnets. I want a fresh pair of fishnets for Saturday's festival day. So I'm gonna go run to Target real quick and do that. And then I'm gonna actually start packing and get ready to start packing. I gotta really pack because we're leaving the house in about 13 hours. No. We literally take off. We take off. Our flight leaves and 12 hours, so we leave here in about 8. Okay, no worries, besties. I'll get you with an update soon, okay? Bye-bye. Hey, besties, it is now 9:38 p.m. I'm about to get started on packing, finally. Literally about to get started on packing. I'm supposed to leave for the airport in like 6 hours, 7 hours, and I haven't started packing, but it's okay. We're watching some Ginny and Georgia with the homie while I pack, and then I'm gonna try and get some Z's if I can, and then I gotta wake up early as fuck so that I can do my makeup and be ready so that when we land in Texas by 1:30 p.m., I'm just ready to go for the day and I don't have to, like, do my makeup or anything. And so we can just go have a full day of Texas because Saturday and Sunday, like I said, I'm at the festival. So this is literally all I'm working with now. I ran to Target and I got me some new fishnets because I, wanted a fresh pair of these guys for the festival, and then I just got one of these two because the other ones were really falling apart. So yeah, a new toothbrush because I don't like traveling with my toothbrush. I just feel like it's weird, like you're, like, carrying bacteria everywhere. So every time I travel, I just get like a new, like, really cheap toothbrush to use for the travel. I will check in a little bit with like a little check-in on how I'm doing with the packing, or when I'm done. Fingers crossed I can get it done before like midnight or something. 9:30. Let's hope.
Hello, besties. It's 12:45 a.m. I am just about done packing everything. It's been a process. I guess I'll show you guys my process at this moment. Let's do that.
This very moment, I'm trying to figure out what my carry-on bag should be. If it should just be like this Maggie Lindman tote. So I'm deciding between this backpack and that. I just don't want them to stop me for anything. This is so far what we're looking at here. I just have like this packing case thing because I am a horrible overpacker, if you can't tell just by looking. This is for like a weekend trip. I did even plan my like outfits for the days and stuff, but I don't know. I'd rather overpack than underpack. That's just how always I am. I feel safe. I've yet to like fill in these spots, but I have the curling wand, little blow dryer thing. And this side here is like all my socks, fishnets, accessories and stuff, undies, good stuff like that. And then here's my Converse.
Toast. Where'd you go? Hey, yo, baby doll. No? Okay.
I have even what I'm planning to wear tomorrow to the airport
right here.
Just need to finish up the last little details. Let me show you guys. I'm like insane. So I have my MacBook in here. I just have like an extra layer of protection on it. I wish I had like a cushion protector, but I don't. Oh, this is all my jewelry and whatnot. All my jewelry in here. This probably won't be as big tomorrow because I'm probably gonna put on some of the jewelry before I head out. I have this backpack, which is probably what I'm gonna take to the festival because it's really small. But yeah. And then my makeup is all in here. This is the smallest I've ever, like, gotten it down to, I feel like. It's pretty good on me. But, listen. Listen. This bag, though, she's the problem. Okay, it's hard to, like, fit all your liquids in. Like, literally, look at this. This is all my hair care and skin care. And then my foundation. And, like, lotion and body wash and perfume. But, like, how do people... I can't. I don't understand, like, how...
I'm just high maintenance, I guess. Hi, besties. It is now 1:43 a.m. I basically have everything I need together. I just have like my sunglasses, face makeup, jewelry, MacBook, charging stuff, batteries, all that good stuff, liquids, toothbrush, mouth, dental stuff, wallet, of course, bag, one of the bags I'm taking, the suitcase. I'm gonna try and catch some Z's. It is now 5:30 a.m. We're about to head out. I'm not fully done with my makeup, but I'm almost done, so I'm gonna finish it in the car or on the plane or at the airport, either one of them. Outfit's pretty basic today. I have my suitcase ready to go and my little personal bag and then just a little jacket because it's cold here, but it's gonna be hot as hell in Austin or Texas. Hello. We have made it to the airport. The view. Slow. Yeah, these are Delta flights. We are flying Delta straight into, I think it's Dallas Love Field, but just passed TSA, had my booties patted on. It was quite an experience, to say the least. Our flight did get delayed by like half an hour, like 45 minutes-ish, so I think I'm gonna try and grab some coffee or food and then get on the flight, and I shall update y'all when I do. It is like 5:30 p.m. now. I'm at a mall because a little stupid little bitch like me, if you notice anything different, I forgot my nose ring when I was leaving for the airport today, so I just had to go buy some at Hot Topic. We are, I don't even know where we are really. We're like downtown. I don't know if you can see like Dallas back there. And then there's like really cool mural over there. We're about to go have some barbecue down in this like really cool strip area. We're all beat. I need sleep. Again, we did decide on this really nice barbecue spot that had live music. It was such a fun vibe. I had this loaded pulled pork nachos. It was pretty yummy. Yeah, that's what I'll be at. Let's go.
After dinner, we did kind of walk around the little downtown area a little bit to check out the murals and wall paintings, check out, you know, just all the representation and creativity. It was quite beautiful and such a good time. And then we went down to see where JFK was assassinated. This was actually surreal and such a beautiful sight as well. Crazy to think of the history that happened here. If you wanted a closer look, these three X's that are painted on the pavement are actually where all the final bullets were administered, the first two and the last one there.
Hi, besties. It is still Friday. It is 10:53 p.m. I'm shot again, y'all. I haven't slept in like 20 hours. No. 18. Right? No. I haven't slept in like 36 hours. Wow. So we had a long day. Crazy day. Went and saw where JFK was assassinated. We did see some street artwork, and that was basically it. My dad's not cheaters. I think I am gonna work on scheduling some posts before tomorrow that my editor sent me, and then I'm gonna go to bed because tomorrow's SoWhat Fest, and I need to be as energized as possible because it's gonna be like extreme heat advisory. It was gross today. It's supposed to be like 98 tomorrow. It's humid as hell and like 106 or something on Sunday. It's gross. But yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and basically relax for the rest of the night and then go to bed. Like I said, it's 10:54, so I'll probably be to bed by like midnight or one, hopefully. And then I can wake up by 8 or 9. Good morning, one. Good morning, all. I'm awake. I think it's about to be like 9 a.m. Gotta start getting ready here soon. See, I don't know why my hair is doing this. I think there was too much product in my hair last night, and it was so cold in here that my hair like didn't fully air dry. So I'm dealing with this, and then the humidity of Texas. So I don't know what to do with my hair, really. Other than that, though, look at this, y'all. I'm like ready to go. Got my little bag set aside and my outfit. A little schoolgirl, the band-aids on deck, you already know, the power banks, two pairs of socks, and band-aids. I'm gonna go ahead and do my makeup and try and get to the festival ground by like either noon or one, because music doesn't start playing till one, and there's not really anyone I want to see today other than PTV, or anyone of relevance to me till like 4 o'clock. Lolo's at two, but today's more of a chill day. Tomorrow's my running around day. Today's more so just like fill in the space to get a good spot for PTV. Little update for y'all. It is 10:21 a.m. I'm almost done with my makeup. Gonna figure out what to do with my hair. I don't know if I should just like straighten it. I know I want to do two little half up pigtails, and I don't know if I should straighten it, like blow dry it straight or curl it, even though I know the humidity will have my curls falling out by the time I get to the festival. So I don't know. And then I think the festival opens at noon, but the music sets don't start till 1. So do you guys see the video? You guys see those I keep dropping pearls everywhere. Do you guys see those videos of on TikTok? And they're like, how to talk to a cat. Mah. Come here. Mah. People in the Airbnb next door probably think I'm crazy for talking to myself. All right, bestie boos. The makeup has been completed. She's a little cute girl. You know, doing the damn thing. All right. The hair is done. She's kind of cute. I don't know. Something is wrong with my hair today. I think I maybe left too much product in it last night. Just a little like greasy, oily, girly pop. And I'm just like not having it. I'm hoping that she stays somewhat maintainable today. But seeing as we're going to be in 100 degree Dallas humidity, I don't really know. And for my makeup, I don't know how she's going to hold up. So take a good look at it because this is the best it's going to look all freaking day. I'm ready to go. So what? I think it's, what time is it? Oh, it is 12:18 right now. So I'm about to call an Uber to take me to Starbucks on the way there so I can get a coffee
water and something to eat because I haven't really been eating well the last day. I'm not well rested and I'm gonna need the water today. It's like 100 degrees outside. It's super humid. Thankfully, half of the festival is indoors, half of it's outdoors, so we do get like periods of time where we can go inside and cool down with the AC, and there is free refill water stations, so we're really lucky with that. My friend's bringing a hydration pack. Shout out to you, Miss Pika girl. You're a lifesaver. Thank you.
Hey, y'all. This is Le Funnel outfit. Doc Martens, fishnets. I've got a nice little, like, yoga skirt that has shorts built into it because it's a music festival. You don't know what's going to happen. Best way to stay safe, keep my cheekies from showing. And if I want to crowd surf, no one can shove their hand where I don't want it. Got this corset, my backpack, got my makeup bag in here, two battery packs, an extra SD card, chargers, my wallet, and camera. So, oh, and the sunnies that will go in there as well. I think it's time for me to go. Here I come, so what? Be ready for me. My Uber is about to arrive. I'm just doing one last walkthrough, make sure I don't forget anything. I hope not, because that's about the walkthrough I'm gonna do. Shaky. All right, let's go to SoWhat. Yeah! I don't think the lighting is very good here. I apologize. I also have stuffed my face with a little sandwich I have. I have coffee and drinks I need to finish off before I go walk in. This is what it's looking like over there. The entrance over here is actually like a really pretty part. It is way too fucking hot out here. I just picked up my wristband. Gonna go ahead and hit the entry and then meet up with my friends, wherever the fuck they are. So I will update y'all in just a second.
Editing this here, get used to this face. You're gonna see it a little bit throughout this video. I did a horrible job of updating y'all. There was lackluster updates throughout the festival, just because the sun really overstimulated me. The humidity overstimulated the hell out of me. I was stinky, sweaty, nasty, smelly, and I'm sure y'all understand. So you will see this lovely face and hear this lovely voice every time. I'm gonna give y'all a little update on how the show went, review every set, and just kind of give y'all little updates where I didn't. To start off with the day, I ran in through security, found my friends, got my 21 plus wristband, and we went off inside to the indoor portion where we saw the Hot Topic stage, I believe it was, and got in line at one of the Jack Daniels bars to get our first drinks for the day. We watched 408 perform from the bar line, and they were quite good. Had not heard of them before.
What's up, guys? Are you guys having fun? It's a hot one out there today. I hope you all brought protection. By that I mean sunscreen.
That wasn't on my 2023 bingo card. I won't tell anyone in case it was illegal.
just watched Miss Lolo. Lolo, I'm so sorry, babe. They did you absolutely dirty. And you were freaking out, Miss Girl. She was having a little panic attack because they failed her, but she did amazing.
So unfortunately, we were a couple minutes late to Lolo's set. I wouldn't say we missed more than a couple, like two or three songs. Unfortunately, after we arrived, she did start to experience some technical difficulties, which resulted in her having to go acoustic completely, but she absolutely killed it, and this girl's vocals were on point. She stalled with some jokes to pace through her nervousness, but still did an amazing job with her stage presence, karate interaction, and clean vocals. Another underrated woman in the alternative scene, I'd have to say. I'm definitely an even bigger fan now after seeing her live and having such a great meet and greet experience with her, where she really took the time to meet every single person who came out to go see her or meet her. About this woman was her respect and endearment to ask every fan their name and make sure she asked them before the interaction ended or she walked off. She is a true gem. Seriously, such an amazing woman. Beautiful, hot as hell, sings great, great music. Stream Hot Girls from Hell, her newest release.
Damn, we're gonna head back inside just to cool off a little bit before Scene Queen comes on in about 20 minutes.
Pay my expenses, queen for a day, like a fucking
Big Fantastic. And shake some fucking ass! You get a lot of girls with no choice. Easy plus, easy plus. Get those children off your bus. Easy plus, easy plus. Get those children off your bus. Refreshing page.
Turn this hotel into your mom's house. I need a slut, that's what your mom's for. I'm just trying to let you know I fucked. Did I mention that I fucked? I put the hole in your hotel. You're trying to ride up and down with this bombshell. I'll kick you down with my stiletto. My wings are going out, that's why you can't get on my level. Party in Penn in a big dream house. We'll go in, only one comes out.
Scene Queen, let me shout this from the rooftops. I love this bitch. She is everything I embody, but like as an artist, like she's me, but I'm the streamer version and she's Scene Queen. Like no one's Scene Queen, but you know what I mean? Like we are like same bitch, different fonts. Just the way we talk about topics, support certain things, and just carry confidence in a certain way where we're like body positivity, just the whole nine yards, if you guys know what I'm talking about. She's another great live performer. I had seen many remarks about her raw talent and or music and vocal capabilities when it came to the live aspect. I actually think this bitch is so fucking cool. So cool. She came running out, cheeks out, ass out, baby smooth buns blaring, okay? Made sure to acknowledge important political climates, especially being that we were in Texas, and let anyone in the crowd know that if they were homophobic or a bigot of any sort, they were more than welcome to walk away from the set as it got real gay. I have to stan. Again, I wasn't a huge fan of her beforehand, but I had listened to a couple songs that I thought were cool, funky, fun. I cannot lie, that Vic Fuentes line was fucking naughty. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, insert clip here.
Rich, rich campaign, my expenses, queen for a day, like a fucking Vic Fuentes.
I always love seeking out artists that I have listened to maybe briefly or maybe not even heard of before in a live setting. I just think that's the best way to really discover artists. The live scene is just mwah, chef's kiss. Love it. I just think there's no better way to discover an artist than viewing them live, doing the thing they love most, right? I was not disappointed by any means, and this bitch literally lives on my social feeds now. Like, she's sing queen. She's mother. Yes. She is the perfect artist for the bad bitch bimbos who want to feel cunt when listening to music. Very niche sound, but she works it well and knows what she's doing. Giving Aisha Erotica, maybe, is it Slater? I think Slater, right? She's Slay. Kim Petras almost, but like in a American Barbie bimbo way. Yeah.
Hello, guys. I don't know if I'll be talking loud enough for this, but it's like, it's 4:45 p.m. I just had to take a little break because I almost overheated. My head is like literally drenched. I look like a wet dog. So y'all get that perfect view. Amazing. I think we're going to go try and see Girlfriends and then get a good spot for Pierce the Veil. I know I haven't been vlogging much. It's been a lot with the heat and humidity and whatnot. So recording some sets. I'm so sorry. This table is so uneven.
I know. Literally, I like breathed on it and it was like...
I will update you guys.
You. Especially for you. Right there. I don't want to be the one to say
further into the crowd for this set, even though I actually really enjoyed seeing them and wanted to see them. I just stayed far back. I think my friends wanted to kick it farther back in the crowd and I didn't want to go up alone. I think that was really it. Girlfriends is another band that opened up for The Used and Pierce the Veil on the Creative Control Tour. And you know what? They actually did a really freaking good job doing it. They have really great, fun, interactive songs in ways that they know how to write them for live crowds, which they can interact with them and get feedback. For very fun sets, very fun live shows. They know what they're doing. Just under 3 years, these dudes have banded together and worked their way up to opening for two of the most influential pop punk and or I guess emo bands in the scene. And they are really not inconsiderate to that fact either. We love Humble Kings. I really loved how vocal and talkative their frontman Travis Mills was. He really talked the crowd through their journey and their mission as a band to create music and have a good fucking time playing it live.
If you've ever seen us live before, you've heard me say this, and I can stand up here with conviction night after fucking night because it's something that I truly fucking believe in. And this next song talks about exactly that. It's for y'all. It's called Where Were You? The stars are jumping from the sky. Stack the windows while the whole world falls.
song about masturbation. I think it's like masturbating in the shower or something. So sex positivity is cool. From what I could tell, they weren't using any backing tracks, which is quite astounding that they sounded just like the studio versions live.
Hello, how are you?
What are we recording?
That lady over there.
You need consent to record people.
No, I don't. Fallon!
Chat, how many drinks do y'all think he's had? Fuck.
Chat, is this real?
I don't know, do you feel real?
No, that guy's got purple hair.
He never feels real.
That's a hat, never mind.
Me either. Hello, ghosties. I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to hear me. Basically, I'm walking over to Harper now. The used is about to go on. But since I'm seeing the used anyways next week with Pierce the Veil anyway, I don't really mind missing their set, but I really wanted to see Harper.
Was fucking insane. He kills it. I've been a fan for a minute. So glad I got to see his set. He was so awesome. The crowd and energy and vibe was insane. Really enjoyed his set. I already bought my ticket to see him again when he's on tour here in LA. So catch me there. Probably getting crowd killed. Again, he's another great performer. I think he's a little bit underrated. I'm not even a big rap fan, but him and Killswitch, Jake Hill, were all sets I really enjoyed. And that's coming from someone who does not enjoy rap. Great performer, raps with flow, rhythm, and ease, all while looking good and hyping the crowd up. A plus, underrated artist, for sure. I was able to catch their last couple songs after Harper and right before Pierce the Veil, but it was pretty dead because I'm pretty sure everyone was waiting for Pierce the Veil, other than like the pit or like the main center stage, like first pit of people, you know. They were obviously there for the use and then kind of cleared out for Pierce the Veil. It was just one of those things. I know there's been a lot of debacle and debate about the crowd etiquette when it comes to Pierce the Veil fans, the new TikTok abode of fans, and whatnot. I think I'll probably be doing a YouTube video or something talking about this. I can't say much for the set. I missed most of it. Crowd seemed to enjoy it, but like I said before, it seemed like the crowd was kind of just tapping their feet in anticipation for Pierce the Veil. Staring at the sky,
fast forward to 2023, because of all you guys and everything that we've built together, this next song is number 4 on the alternative charts in America. And I just want to celebrate that with you guys because we built this together and that's what this represents to us. So thank you guys so much. We love you very much. This song goes out to you.
Here's the veil. Y'all know I have nothing but good things to say when it comes to Pierce the Veil. They have and will always be one of my favorite bands when it comes to songwriting, live performance deliveries, and their connection to the fan base, truly. Obviously, I wouldn't fly to Texas to see them a second time and have their album covers tattooed on me if I didn't feel a certain type of way. The crowd etiquette wasn't as bad as I expected, however, it wasn't really a good situation either. I get wanting a good spot for these sets, however, if you want that, get there early and prepare for that instead of taking advantage of people's space or assaulting people, basically. The concert etiquette situation has just been shit overall. I know there's been a lot of argument that it's pierced the veil. I think concert etiquette in general has gone down the little toilet, okay? It's not really just pierce the veil or the hardcore shows. Again, if you're going to a hardcore show, expect there to be moshing. Don't expect people to just stand there singing the lyrics. That's something you have to expect. I've been seeing a lot of retrospect about that as well, is that people can't handle these hardcore shows and the moshing, and concert etiquette is to pick people up. It's to take care of them in the moshes and whatnot, but you gotta expect it. We can only do so much. We cannot coddle you at these shows, you know? Again, I think I'm gonna make a whole separate video on this whole crowd etiquette topic because it's gotten quite out of hand this last year with the surge of TikTok making musicians, artists, and music popular. I want to emphasize it's not a bad thing. I think TikTok's actually a really great skill, or not skill, but a tool that artists and bands have really used to their advantage in the last couple years. And I think it's really working. I think it's really doing the industry wonders and small artists wonders. I also think the lack of crowd etiquette is due to teenagers who are now going to shows, being old enough to go to these shows, and they're COVID kids. You know, they got taken out of school and they lack the social awareness and etiquette they need to go about these social outings and events. Food for thought.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I just got home, and are you ready for the reveal of a lifetime?
Can you tell that I don't go in the sun?
This is what I looked like before the festival. Okay, and this is what I look like after the festival. I'm gonna go ahead and take a cold shower. I got bagel bites and water, and half a bag of hot Cheetos left, and I'm gonna pass the fuck out and wake up for tomorrow. Like, what happened here? Everyone who said I was slain, serving, conscious, pretty, makeup was good, y'all lied to me. Hey y'all, I've returned from my shower and I am completely and utterly beat, to say the least. My scalp is also burned. Quite the assortment of like bruises going on here too. Like I must have been kicked a lot, I'm guessing. Like I said, I've got quite the assortment of bruises going on. So I'm gonna go make those bagel bites and then I am going to relax, look at some of the stuff I took, make sure I still have enough storage on my phone for tomorrow. I cannot believe I have to go through another day tomorrow. Like, y'all, this burn is actually, like, ridiculous. Like, I don't know if y'all see this, but, like, like, this is absolutely, I have never burned like this in my life. Like, I haven't burned in years. Hopefully, I'm not in excruciating pain tomorrow. because I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do another full day if that's the case. It doesn't look like my face got too burnt, so that's good. Elf's SPS 30 primer coming in handy. Oh, also, my heels are raw. Triple band-aided on each heel, double socked, even wore my Twitch socks, which are like really thick, like socks. And steel, yes, and I got really blisters to the point where I'm like missing a chunk of skin out of my heel, and it's just completely raw. And like, it didn't even hurt that bad. Like, I was like, oh, that's a little uncomfortable, but I just assumed like, it was just a little bit of friction. Not that my whole fucking like back of my heel was gone, and I would show y'all, but I don't trust the internet. No free feet. I'm honestly really contemplating wearing either no makeup tomorrow or like just like eyeliner, like eye makeup and like lipstick. Just because, I mean, I have nice skin anyway, so it doesn't really bother me if, like, I'm not insecure to not have foundation on. I just like the way my full face of makeup looks. So I just, again, y'all, this is what I looked like after 12 hours today in 100 degree Texas humidity. So, yeah, thinking maybe no face makeup tomorrow and I could squeeze by with like light eye makeup, because my eyeliner I think my eyeliner was fine up until I saw Harper and Pierce the Veil possibly, because after I left Pierce the Veil, this whole eye was running, like my whole face basically in this area was gone, like it was gone, and then like the, it was so bad, guys. There was like a couple points I wanted to make, like reviewing the festival. There's just so many things I want to talk about, because like I know that's something that like I want to share my experience, right? From the entrances and exits that were a little unorganized, to the staff and security that wasn't always the nicest or most helpful, to literally waiting an hour and a half in a taco line and then getting my order literally skipped over.
Let me tell you. These food lines were fucking ridiculous. The food lines were all crazy. I think day one, they realized they did not have nearly as many vendors as they needed to create lines and consistency and not restrain people from going about their sets and seeing the shows or the sets that they wanted to, basically. Again, all the lines were long as hell for mid-ass fucking food, but they tried. You know, you can only do so much. I'm pretty sure the extent of my burn came from standing in line for over an hour for a $20 plate of carne asada fries that I had to wait way too long for and get skipped over in line. It was just a whole mess. Didn't even finish it all because it was weird. It made me feel weird later. Like, my stomach hurt later in the night, but it wasn't like a, like, shitting your pants or throwing up type, like, hurt. Like, it just made me feel like the food I ate was just not sanitary. I don't know how else to explain it. I will give SoWhat points for giving a plant-based option for the vegans and vegetarians. I'm not even like a vegan or vegetarian, but I think it's really good to have those options available anywhere, because it's how do you expect them to sustain? Again, I'm pretty sure day two, they ended up bringing out a couple more vendors, as they said by post, social media posts, but I did hear backlash again about that. They didn't add enough vendors. There wasn't good food, yada, yada, yada. I think the food situation just wasn't it. I will say them having free refillable water stations was great. Even if it was tap water or unfiltered water, we were dying, so we all needed the water.
To seeing this lady with her titties out in underwear getting arrested, and the street says that she was mollied out. Yeah, it was just a lot. I will say, and I hate that I have to reiterate this point, I hate that this is true, TikTok culture has absolutely ruined the way we experience live music. And not necessarily just in terms of the phones and everything. I'm the first person that will be like, dude, take out your phone, take out your camera, I don't care. I was recording on both my camera and my phone. But what I don't agree with, what I don't think is good concert etiquette, is, and you can tell who's younger and you can tell who's like literally there just for Pierce the Veil. They come in after the used, and like all of us are already standing there, like a whole line of people, like of like 10 people literally shoved me to the side and walked past me, and I was like, no. I literally looked at this dude and I was like, no, like, dude, you, that's not right, like, you're not doing that. And he's like, well, I am, and continued to shove me out of the way and keep pushing, and his friends kept shoving me out of the fucking way too, so I just ended up body bagging them, and I kept putting my body weight into them when they kept moving by, because you're gonna give me a hard time, I'm gonna give you a fucking harder time. Same dude who was line leader of that group ended up, we were like, I'll show y'all where we were from the video of Pierce the Veil, where we were in relation to the stage. I'd say like no more than 50 feet back, probably like just pivotal, like just to the left of center stage. There was no moshing yet. Please mosh as much as you want. Love the mosh pits. I personally haven't gone in the mosh pits yet, just because I'm always carrying so many things and I haven't seen a mosh pit safe enough yet for me, or one that I'm prepared for, should I say. By all means, mosh. I love mosh pits. I love to ride the outside because I get to experience it while also not having to get hurt or anything. But dude started moshing, and he literally was the only one who started it, and he just started pushing people who didn't want to be included in moshing. They were trying to enjoy the show individually in that style however they wanted, right? And he kept pushing people, and I remember this like colored hair girl, and like, I don't know if it was bikini top, fishnets, like all black. She was very much my style too, and she literally looked back and she was like, dude, fucking stop. I keep noticing that the concert etiquette is just so out the window. And I'm someone who's new to the live scene, like the live music scene, and I'm saying that. I'm going to say goodnight, and you guys will see me in the morning. I hope, if I don't die from this sunburn. Okay, goodnight.
To recap all of day one, TLDR, the exit and entrance pathing and management needed work and or improvement. More food vendors would have been appreciated due to the expected attendance, so lines and hours were not causing festival goers to be restricted from the sets they expected to be seen, or exposing them to the extra heat and sun that we did not need. Concert etiquette is at an all-time low, but we all knew that. I will give extra points to this festival and really just the population of the crowd for not reeking of body odor, and especially in Texas heat and humidity above 90 to 95 degrees. I really give y'all that, especially it being a hardcore genre mesh music festival. I applaud y'all. I don't think I smelled BO once the entire show. Maybe sweat, which is normal, but BO? The deodorant y'all using? It's working. Keep it up. Guys, that's award worthy for an alternative festival. Other than that, I thoroughly enjoyed day one of SoWhat Music Festival, other than being horribly burnt and swapping bodily fluids, meaning sweat, and probably spit with a lot of people. Let's get on to day two.
And again, land in your day, pumping grinds on the